Hello students, welcome back to our SST classroom. Now students, in the last video we started our chapter, right? That is lesson number 6, local self government. Okay, so students, in that we have discussed about what is local self government. So students, local self government, it exists in all states of India at the grassroots level, right? This we have discussed in the last video. It assigns the duties and responsibilities of development of urban and village, right? Okay, and also we discuss about there are the 3 types of local self government. They are Nagar Panchayat, Municipal Council, Municipal Corporation. Students, in the last video we discuss Nagar Panchayat, right? And students, in this video we are going to discuss the next concept, that is Municipal Council and Municipal Corporation. So let's start. Students, a town or a city has its own local government called the municipal council. Okay students, town or city has its own local government and is called municipal council. Okay students, the member of municipal council are called municipal councillors. Okay, the member of the municipal council are called municipal councillor. Students, it is suitable for town or small city. Okay students, it is suitable for town and or small city. Okay, now I hope you have understood about municipal council. Students, municipal council, it take care of the needs and the problem of a people in the town or city. Okay, now we'll talk about the next concept, that is municipal corporation. Students, in metropolitan cities, you know which are the metropolitan cities? We have discussed in the last video, that is Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai. So students, in metropolitan cities, municipal corporation are made for local administration. Can say in the big cities there are municipal corporation. Okay, who took care of the people and who provides the needs of the people. Students, the head of the municipal corporation is called a mayor. Okay, so what is the head of municipal corporation called? Mayor. Okay, we have discussed students in the village panchayat, we have discussed about Indian village, the head of the panchayat is known as sarpanch, right? So here also the head of municipal corporation is called mayor. Okay students, the corporation has a council that is directly elected by the local people. Okay, all the members of municipality are directly elected by the people of municipal area. Okay, means people, they elect the member for municipal corporation. Okay. Okay students, I hope till here you have understood. Now students, we'll discuss about the income of municipalities. Students, to do all the welfare work, municipalities need money, right? To do all the welfare work, municipalities need money. So students, from where they will get money? They get money by charging a fixed amount as a fee or tax on land and houses. Okay, people pay tax for water, electricity and use of roads. Okay students, they also pay entertainment tax and tax on vehicles. Okay, so through this tax, the people, they get money to do welfare for the people. Okay, students, central or state government provide grants for improvement and development of infrastructure and institution. Okay, students. Students, now we will discuss about the function of municipality. Okay, students, it makes arrangement for cleanliness of the cities. It makes arrangement for lighting on the road and street at night. Okay, and street light at night. It provides clean drinking water. It is also responsible for improvement of slums. Also responsible for improvement of slums area. It's run primary school for children. Okay students, it makes arrangement for registration of birth and death. It provides facilities for public health, sanitization and solid waste management. It provides burial grounds, cremation grounds and electric aromatoriums, etc. Okay students, it makes arrangement for fire station and dispensary. So these all are the functions of municipalities. Okay students, I hope till here you have understood. Now we'll discuss about cooperative societies. Students, recently cooperative society have been formed as an institution that work for the welfare of their members. Okay students, farmer cooperative provide loan assistance and other help to the farmers. Okay students, so cooperative means among them a group they form to help their members. So like take example of farmer cooperatives. So farmer cooperatives, it provide loan assistance and other help to the farmers. Small traders and cooperative provide easy loan and other help to small traders in towns and cities. Okay students, there are cooperative societies that sell things at low rates. They also sell school books, handicraft and other stationery. Okay, cooperative societies are formed in village, town and cities. Okay students, so where it form? It form in a village, town and cities. So these cooperative society also sell the things at low rates. So they also sell school books, handicraft and other stationery. Okay students, women cooperative society provide loan to women for setting up small scale business. If the women they want to set up a business, so this women cooperative is a women cooperative society. It gives us loan to the women for setting up small scale business. Okay students, I hope you all have understood this chapter. Okay, thank you.